So, dear students, let us see what are the basic terminologies in the compiler. If we are talking about the compiler, we should know about what are the basics behind that. Compiler is nothing but a program, or you can say a translator, which converts a program written in one language into a program written in another language. So it's a kind of translator. So in this translator, we use some terminologies like lexemes, tokens, patterns, okay, language, words, and all. So one by one, we will look these three. What is lexeme? So first of all, I am talking about lexeme. So lexeme is a sequence of characters in a source program that matches the pattern for a token and is identified by the lexical analyzer as an instance of that token. It means whenever we are scanning a particular string, okay, and one by one finding the characters, let we have a string ABC, then A is a lexeme, B is a lexeme, and C is a lexeme. Or we can say that ABC whole as a lexeme, because it is one of the smallest part of your program. So once it will matches with some token scenario, well, once we can say that it is kind of token, that this is called a smallest unit, then this is called a lexeme. So tokens and lexemes, both we can use interchangeably, but when we are talking about any source program and scanning from left to right and finding some tokens, then deciding the token before that, we tell it lexeme. Similarly, a token is a pair of consisting of a token name and an optional attribute value. So once you find the lexeme, after that, if we provide some attribute to them, then it will become a token. Attribute is kind of additional information, like it is a keyword, like it is a identifier, or it is a constant, or whatever. So when we combine lexeme with some attribute, then it will form a token. So sometimes they both can use interchangeably. Now we are talking about the patterns. A pattern is a description of a form that the lexeme of a token may take. Which kind of pattern that we are using to form the tokens? In the case of a keyword as a token, the pattern is just a sequence of characters that form the keyword. If you are talking about the sequence of numbers, if you are talking of sequence of symbols, so these are different kind of things. If you are talking about sequence of characters, then definitely it will form a keyword. So there should be some pattern to write the token and the lexemes. So these are some important terminologies that we need to use in the compiler. Now I am talking about the alphabets. Now what are the alphabets? Alphabets are nothing but the set of characters, symbols, and your digits. Like your 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 9, then A, B, C, D up to Z, small a to Z. These are our alphabets. So any combination of these alphabets will form a string. Okay, if we are using ABC 1 2 3, then the combination of ABC and 1 2 3, this whole will bring a string for us. Okay, so always remember this: a string is nothing but the use of alphabets in a particular order. Okay, so finite sequence of these alphabets is called a string, and the length of the string is total number of occurrence of the alphabets. A string is having no alphabet, then we can call it null string. Okay, so always remember, a string will be formed using the alphabets, and alphabets are nothing but your 0 to 9 and A to Z, and possibly some symbols. Now we are talking about the language. Okay, the language always is a set of strings. Okay, once we have alphabets, then we have strings. Now we have language. So language is considered as a finite set of string over some finite set of alphabets. Computer languages are considered as finite sets, and mathematically set operations can be performed on them. Let we have a language of all string starting with A. This is a language. We consider all words over A to Z starting with A, like apple, like annotation, like area. So these all are the word which are starting with character, or you can say symbol, or you can say alphabet A. So set of these words will form a language. Okay, so language, when we are talking about the language, there should be a grammar. That means the rules, regulation of writing the language. Okay, now if we are talking about the language is further divided into two categories, like high level languages and the low level languages. So high level languages are the languages which are understandable by the human being very easily, like our English language, like our Hindi language, like Urdu and whatever. And also we call them the natural languages. Okay, so these are easily understandable by the human being. If we are writing something in C++ or Java or Pascal or Python, so these are somewhat understandable by the human being like us. Okay, if we know about the English and some basic concepts of mathematics, then we can easily understand what is written there. So every computer language in general is a high level language. And there is another category that is called low level language. Then it is a language which is easily understandable by the machine. Machine is any kind, any microprocessor languages. So further, your low level language is further divided into two, that is assembly language and the binary language. Assembly language are used for some microprocessors like Intel 8085, 8080, 8086, 286, 386, Intel Pentium 1, 2, 3 and whatever. Okay, so these are the assemblers. For this, the language is called the assembly language. And if it is written in the binary language, by like in 0-1 form, if you are writing something in 0-1, 0-1, 0, and if you are writing capital A, then maybe like it is 0-1, 1-0, 1-0, 1-0, and it is recognized as capital A, then the language is considered as machine language. That means the low level languages are easily understandable by the machine only, not by the human being. And for the human being, it is not very easy, or you can say it is not easy for a human to write any program in the machine language. It is very, very complex thing. Okay, so this is all about the languages, and in the next video we will learn another thing. Thank you.